How are you? I am Pooja Parihar, your English teacher from Arden Progressive School, Amachaur. Today it's your third chapter, Taro's Reward. I'm going to explain you this chapter. Before I start this chapter to you, here are some hard words for you written on the board, which I'm going to read one by one for you. First of all, here you can see it's chopped, unexpected, expensive, rushing, kneeling, cupped, delicious, picture, delighted, sick, thereafter swallow, shivering, greedily, procession, intended, knelt, muttering, and encourage. These are the hard words. You will be provided these words and what meaning of these words. So, I'll give you PDF file. You have to complete your work in your notebook and submit me through WhatsApp. Okay.
Taro's Reward. So this story is about taken from Japanese story, translated for you. This story about a thoughtful and loving son. He worked hard to fulfill his parents' wishes and get some unexpected help. So this boy is very hard working and kept on doing hard works for the fulfillment of his parents' wishes, and he gets something unexpected in his life. Let's see what is it. Taro's Reward. A young woodcutter named Taro lived with his mother and father in a lonely hillside. All day long he chopped wood in the forest. Though he worked very hard, he earned very little money. So this boy kept on working hard work. He worked hard and chopped the wood all the day. In return, he earned very little money. And he used to live in a lonely place, hillside place in Japan. This made him sad, for he was a thoughtful son and wanted to give his old parents everything they needed. He was a thoughtful and very loving son, and he wanted to give each and every happiness of life to his parents, but in return he was not getting that much money. That's why he was not happy, he was sad. One evening, even Taro and his parents were sitting in a corner of their hut. A strong wind began to blow. It whistled through the crack of the hut and everyone felt very cold. Suddenly Taro's father said, "I wish I had a cup of sack. It would warm me and do my old heart good." So what happened? One day at the evening time, Taro and his parents were sitting in a corner of their hut. As you know, they were not that much rich. They were not having a pakka house. They used to live in a hut. So they all three were sitting in a corner of their house. Suddenly the strong wind blew and the hut was cracked down. Whistled means there was a cracking voice and the hut was cracked. At the same time, suddenly his father said that, "I wish I might have a cup of sake," and after having the cup of sake, I felt very relieved and in this old age, and my heart will feel good. This made Taro sadder than ever. Sad means sad, not happy. Opposite of happy. Sadder means more sadder than ever. For the heartwarming drink called shake was very expensive. He kept on thinking about the shake which makes my father's heart happy. It would be definitely very expensive. How do I earn more money? He asked himself that then to buy this shake which by having which shake my father's heart will feel happy, it will be expensive. Then how will I get this much money? He was thinking and asking to himself. How do I get a little shake for my poor old father? He decided to work harder than before. So he had decided that I'll do more and more hard work in order to earn more money to buy the shake for his father. Next morning, Taro jumped out of his bed earlier than usual and made him way to the forest. What was his work? His job was to chop the wood. So next morning he got up a little bit earlier and jumped out of his bed and went to forest for chopping the wood, for cutting the wood. He chopped and cut as the sun So he kept on chopping the woods till the evening time. He chopped and cut and the sun climbed, and soon he was so warm and he had to take off his jacket. So very soon it was afternoon and it became very hot, and he has to take out his jacket. His mouth was dry and his face was wet with sweat. My poor father, he thought, if only he was warm as I. He was just thinking about his father wish to have a cup of shake. So that's why he was just thinking about his father. He was very tired at that time and his mouth was dry, and he also wanted to drink something. So that time he was just thinking that at this time, after working hard, I became warm. I hope that my old father might be warm like me. And with that, he began to chop even faster, thinking of extra money he must earn to buy a shake to warm the old man's bone. So from that time, he kept on working and he kept on chopping in order to earn more and more money in order to buy the shake for his father. Then suddenly Taro stopped chopping. What was the sound he heard? Could it possibly be rushing water? So suddenly when he was chopping the wood, cutting the wood, he heard something and he stopped working and he asked to himself that what it could be. Possibly it a running water. Taro could not remember ever hearing a rushing stream in the part of the forest. He was thirsty. The axe dropped out of his hand and ran in the direction of the sound. So he earlier, because he was very familiar to this area of the forest, because daily he came here and used to cut the wood, but he never heard about the stream or the noise of the running water over here. So he became surprised that is here the water stream there. So he dropped his axe and went in the direction of the voice of the water to have some water and to see the stream. Taro saw a beautiful little waterfall hidden behind a rock. Kneeling at a place where the water followed quietly, he cupped a little in his hands and put it to his lips. Was it water or was it sake? He tasted it again and always it was delicious sake instead of cold water. So what happened? So when he reached that place, he saw that there was a very beautiful, wonderful stream, waterfall there, and that was just behind the rock. He was there and he just went to the place where the waterfall was and followed the water quietly and quietly went to that place, to the water where that there was a stream, there was a waterfall, the water was coming down. He went there, he cupped a little in his hand. Cupped means he put a little much water like this, cupped a little in his hands and it to his lips like this way, and he drank it, means lip, his lips means drank it. Was it water or was it shake? He became surprised that is this water or shake was, what is it? He was just thinking. He tasted it again and again for the confirmations. He tasted this liquid again and again that it is water or what is this? And always it was delicious shake instead of cold water. But each and every time when he tasted it, it was not water, it was a delicious shake. Taro quietly filled the pitcher he had with him and hurried home. So you can see in the picture that Taro were having a pitcher on his shoulder. So he filled the pitcher very quickly and went to home. Hurried to home means very fastly he went to his home. The old man was delighted with a shake. So who is the old man here? His father, Taro's father, is the old man, and he wanted to have a cup of shake. Delighted with the shake means after having the shake, he became very delighted. He became very happy. After only one swallow of the liquid, he stopped shivering and did a little dance in the middle of the floor. Just after having a single sip, the old man shivering went away and he started a little dance in middle of his and of the floor. That afternoon, a neighbor stopped by for a visit. Taro's father politely offered her a cup of shake. The lady drank it greedily and thanked the old man. Then Taro told her the story of the magic waterfall, thanking them for the delicious drink. She left in a hurry. By nightfall, she had spread the story throughout the whole village. So what happened? There was a neighbor who came to Taro's house. Taro's father offered the tasty shake to the lady. She drank it very greedily and thanked the old man. And before it's night, she spread the story to the whole village about that delicious shake. That evening, there was a long procession of visitors to the woodcutter's house. Each man heard the story of a waterfall and took a sip of the shake. Is less than an hour, the pitcher was empty. So every woodcutter of the village came to Taro's house and everyone took a sip from the pitcher, and within half an hour the pitcher was empty. Next morning Taro started for work even earlier than the morning before. He carried with him the largest pitcher he owned, for he intended first of all to go to the waterfall. When he reached it, he found to his great surprise all his neighbors there. They were carrying pitchers, jars, buckets, anything they could find to hold the magic stick. Then one villager knelt and held his mouth under the waterfall to drink. He drank again and again and then shouted angrily, "Water? Nothing but water." Other also tried, but there was no sick, only cold water. So what happened next morning? Taro went for his work more earlier, and he took a bigger one pitcher, and took it and went to jungle. And first of all, he decided to fill the pitcher. But when he went there near the stream, what he seen there, his neighbor was each and every neighbor was there, and everyone was having buckets, pitchers, whatever they were having, they kept along with them for the delicious sake there. And one person just tried at first to drink the shake, and he shouted that, "What is this? This is a simple cold water, not a shake." And after that, one by one, each and every one just tasted that liquid, and everyone was shouted that this is not a shake, this is a simple water. "We have been tricked," shouted the villagers. "Where is Taro? Let us drown him in this waterfall." But Taro had been wise enough to slip behind a rock. When he saw his how things were going, he was nowhere to be found. So what happened? Villagers shouted that he has tricked with us, means he made us fool. Where is the boy Taro? We will just draw him in this waterfall. Draw means he will just put him in this water and kill him. After knowing this, Taro was very smart. He just hid himself, and he was not found anywhere. Muttering their anger and disappointment, the villager left the place one by one. Taro came out from his hiding place. Was it true? He wondered. Was the sake a dream? Once more he caught a little liquid in his hand and put it in his lips. It was the same fine sake. To the thoughtful son, the magic waterfall gave the delicious sake to everyone else. It gave only cold water. So after that, muttering and in a disappointment, each and every villager went from there. When everyone left that place, Taro came out, and he was also surprised that is it true that this is not a shake, it's a simple water? What is going on? When I had tasted, it was a tasty shake, and I gave to everyone. Everyone was enjoyed. And at that time, the taste of this shake was delicious, tasty. And then what happened right now? What's wrong with its taste? Why everyone is saying that it's a simple water, not tasty shake? So again, he tried for this shake, this water or shake, whatever. He just put nearer to his mouth and tasted it. It was the same delicious taste, tasty shake. It was the same fine shake. To the thoughtful son, the magic waterfall gave the delicious shake He was saying it, this is the magic waterfall and giving the delicious shake to me, to everyone else. It gave only water and rest of the people. This waterfall is giving water and to me it's giving a shake. That is interesting for him. The story of Taro and his magic waterfall reached the emperor of Japan. He sent for the young woodcutter and rewarded him with the 20 pieces of gold for having been so good and kind. Then he named the most beautiful fountain in the city after Taro. This, said the emperor, was to encourage all children to honor and obey their parents. So what happened after that? The story of Taro and his magic waterfall reached to the emperor of Japan. As earlier, at first I told you this story is translated from Japanese story for you. So after knowing all the story was anyhow reached to the emperor of the Japan. So this emperor of Japan called the young woodcutter Taro and rewarded him 20 pieces of gold. Imagine, he was just simple, a poor woodcutter. He has just to fulfill his basic requirement of food for himself and his parents, and he was rewarded with 20 pieces of gold for having so good and kind. Why he was so good and kind? He distributed the cake to each and everyone around him, and each and everyone has tasted the delicious cake, isn't it? Then he named the most beautiful fountain in the city after Taro. So the city and the beautiful fountain waterfall was named behind Taro. This, said the emperor, and after that the emperor said was to encourage all the children to honor. Means he's announced that each and every children should be encouraged to obey their parents. Because in this story also, this Taro was obeyed and loving son to, isn't it? That's why he always kept on thinking about his fulfill the requirement of his parents. That's why. Okay, that is it. Till thank you each and everyone, beta. Thank you. Bye bye.